My name's Chris Scaminaci. I'm the VP of Engineering over at TechPulse Professional Services and also the ninth degree Halo PSA wizard known as Siege the MSP Automator of MSPAutomator.com. Today, I'm here to tell you that you're doing time tracking wrong. The biggest complaint I hear from MSP partners is that the time tracking in Halo PSA is difficult and convoluted and not organic. Almost every time that I've heard this complaint, it's unsubstantiated because people really don't understand or appreciate how simple and natural the time tracking is in Halo if you have it set up correctly. The things that you're going to want to have set up in time management for just about any scenario, right? You're going to want to track your non-billable time. You're going to want to track your travel time usually, even if you're not charging for those things. You want to know how much time they account for. You also maybe want to capture your travel time and actions, or maybe even your distance traveled if you have to reimburse mileage, right? But really what it comes down to is start your timer when you open your ticket, show your read-only actions, set your timesheet interval to as small as you want it to be, and give your agents a start time and end time. Now, when you're actually recording your time and your tickets, you're opening your ticket. If you have good ticket hygiene, your timer is going to start when you open your ticket. It's going to continue to run. And when you do any kind of action on the ticket, you're going to record your time, right? I see people really overcomplicate this a lot. All you need to do is make this organic, capture your time taken, capture your charge rate, make sure these are required fields for any kind of action inside of the system, right? And then you train your staff to say, if you're not going to have good ticket hygiene and you want to have a bunch of tabs open and work your tickets throughout the day, that's fine. Just make sure that this field is correct and this field is correct anytime you save something. That's all you have to do. Then maybe you want to come back and log some time against something, you know, ad hoc, or you want to log retroactive time. You can do that. All you have to do is select the ticket. That's time tracking. Now, that goes to your timesheet in Halo, and your timesheets are maybe a little bit confusing to understand at first, but really what it breaks down to is your start time is your first action for the day in Halo, your finish time is the last action for the day in Halo, and your target hours are how many hours Halo thinks you should be working that day. Your target hours are set by your work day. Your hours worked are hours that Halo physically saw you present. It was pinging your browser. It knew you were there doing something. You were, you know, logged in between the hours of start time and finish time, which were two actions, right? And your hours logged is the actual amount of time you've logged against tickets that day. Some of these icons, your start times, your finish times. If there's questions about what these are, you'll see the little X's here. And if you press the check marks that appear, you would be able to see that you're just confirming these things. That's a review of a timesheet, right? Simple as that. And at the end of the week, you'll see what your target hours would have been, how many you actually worked, and how many you actually logged. That's it. It's time tracking in Halo PSA. You can get some really creative reporting done with this. Thanks for watching, guys. If you have any questions, let us know.